This is a Wallaway contest, three-minute rounds, and now, fighting out of the blue corner, he weighed in at 74.6 kilograms, from Oslo, Norway, Frontline MMA, Benny Sariba! And now, fighting out of the red corner, he weighed in at 73.2 kilograms, from Rochdale, Full Contact Performance Center, Adam Hussein! Referee is Mr. Jay Furness. Ladies and gentlemen, let's Marvin Gaye and get it on.
On to our next bout of the evening. Here at Ice FC. I'm Jamie the Haymaker Hay here as always with E&M 16 Butlin. Ready for our next bout. Adam Hussein taking on Bani Sariba. Bani coming over from Norway for this fight.
Yeah, and the Scandinavians are famous for being not just strong fighters, but very, very good technical groundwork, good striking. You'll see a lot of them on the M1 Global and other shows around Europe.
Yeah, these, you know, like you say, you've seen a lot of them in Eastern Europe, haven't you, over the last couple of years, especially. They are starting to come over here now, you know, fighting over here.
The Scandinavians, the Icelandics, you know, they've got very good groundwork, very good striking, really good all-rounders, and just so tough. These are bred from Vikings.
Hussein moving Hussein, forward, yeah, throwing bombs.
Looking good.
So far, good head movement from Hussein, though. Goes with that low kick himself.
Very good corner. It's a beautiful right. He's wobbled him.
He's definitely wobbled him there. He's shut the eye as well. He doesn't know where he is at the minute, I don't think, Bani.
Hussein, another good right hand.
Yeah, he's definitely rocked him quite badly here. He needs to capitalise on this, Ian.
Oh, it was a solid shot. It was right on the bone of it, underneath his eye. Look there, Hussein. This is great work.
Superb catch there of the leg.
You can see the corner there, Martin Stapleton, Derek Cullen, Trent Sim in the corner for Full Contact Performance Centre.
Yeah, Hussein now needs to get that composure, move forward and really capitalise on the damage that he's already done. That left eye looks a bit swollen as well.
It really does. I think it's going to close shut.
Yeah, I think it caught him right.
He might be getting his head back together now, but there's some damage done there. It's got to be giving Hussein confidence.
Yeah, definitely. I think the way Hussein caught him with that one, like I say, it was a one sort of punch. Didn't follow up with it though. Again, he's just done the same there. Caught him with the other hand. And not followed up though. Really nice kick from Bani.
Oh, beautiful right left uppercut right hand. Sorry. Hussein letting Bani back into the fight here.
Yeah, he just needs to slow the pace down slightly. He's throwing too many single shots for my liking here. I think Hussein needs to... Oh, nice front kick there, straight to the face. Hussein felt that, but took it on the chin.
Literally, but he caught it through the right hand of his own. This is becoming a very well-matched fight, this.
Yeah, I think, like I say, Hussein needs to start throwing more.
Come on, ladies, get behind these guys, come on!
Just the single shots aren't good enough, even though he has got some really good power. Caught a knee there on the way down. Up against the cage now, last 10 seconds.
Still looking good and strong. This is definitely a round for Hussein.
Yeah, you know,
but it's been by no means one-sided.
No, it's definitely not been one-sided, and I think Hussein's caught some really good shots. You know, like I say, the only downside to it is he's been too many single shots. He's not followed up enough. You know, he's got a couple of really good punches in, but without any follow-up, you know, it's always hard to get that one-punch knockout, isn't it?
Oh, it certainly is, yeah. Now the corner there of Bani Sariba. The corner of Derek Cullen and Martin Stapleton giving instructions to their fighter. As we said earlier, Martin Stableman just won the Bama lightweight world title.
Yeah. Great win for him against Gav Sterrett.
And as you say, I can remember when both those two walked in the gym as starters, and you could see the potential right from the beginning. Derek, a very, very good judo player. Martin Stableman, one of the fittest guys I've ever met in my life. And I don't mean looks.
Or do you mean looks?
Both.
Yeah.
Male model material, that.
Is it the hair?
Well, I think the hair is making... He's trying to go a bit Zoolander.
And on that note, Zoolander 2 is coming out soon, ladies and gentlemen.
Starring Martin Stableman.
No, he's you know, superb to have a world champion. Yeah, as we're saying there. So,
well, before this round starts again, Jimmy. I love this venue.
Yeah, it's a great venue.
I absolutely love the Ritz has just, for me, it's been the home of Manchester MMA for a long time. You know, I've been involved in the UCC, now with IC, and it's just a great venue.
Yeah, it is.
And the crowd really get behind the fighters.
So, Hussein taking the centre of the cage once again. He's switching up a lot. A nice low kick, catches that. Good work there from Hussein.
Do you know what, it's tough for Hussein, isn't it?
Yeah, very. He's took some big shots on the way down there. He sort of just moves forward, doesn't he? Bani throwing a lot of legs. Not so much in his hands. Again, a nice setup with the hands would be probably worthwhile for him. He'll stop that leg being caught. He's almost throwing that leg on purpose to get caught so he can throw that overhand.
Yeah, he really is. But again, look, Hussein just looks strong in the clinch, you know, very good use of the head, controlling. He's not really looking for the legs so much, but just sort of pushing the head in and driving in.
Yeah,
making Bani think what he's got to do.
He definitely is, but you've got to be careful doing that.
Shots there.
You can tire out quite quickly. And Bani's going a lot to the body now. Really trying to work on Hussein's cardio. And he's a killer, isn't he? You take some body shots, Ian, and your gas tank does go.
It really can drain you. It can really knock you for six. But there we go. Again, Hussein's getting the takedown. Hussein's the one controlling against the fence. He's scoring points here, Jeremy.
Yeah, he definitely is. He's scoring. I think it was a better start to the round, though, for Bani this one. You know, that pressure from Hussein now, I think Bani could probably stand up, to be honest. I think he needs to work to stand up. Both guys looking a little bit tired.
Well, they would be. I mean, it's been a fast pace.
Yeah.
Lots of clinch. Again, look at that. I mean, that takes a lot of effort to stand up like that and then get taken down. That is so disheartening. I've done that in fights myself. You know, you use all that effort to get yourself stood back up only to be put straight back on your back.
Yeah.
Nothing more disheartening.
Hussein's got the game plan now to really keep his man down. And he's climbed into mount. And really, now Ian needs to start putting some pressure on.
I'd like to see him now throwing those combinations in.
It's quite high up mount now. You know, high up mount, not great for working on shots, better for working on submissions.
That's basically a middle mount there, which is very dangerous for getting rolled. You want either a low mount where you're sort of locking up the legs, or a high mount where you're sort of trapping the shoulders.
Yeah.
But at the moment, this is still total dominance here from Hussein.
I'd like to
see him just throwing in the combination, trying to get a finish. At the moment, he's just not quite. Oh, now that's better. Pin in the arm. Bani's still doing a good job, though, of just sort of negating anything that Hussein tries to do.
Yeah. Side control now for Hussein. Yeah, I think, you know, it was a good round there for Hussein. You know, really good work on the takedowns. Very, very good control on the top. I think Bani started off a lot better this round, and I think Hussein's got to be careful in the next round because I think Bani's going to come out swinging.
Yeah. Well, I don't think he's got any choice, Jeremy, to be quite honest.
Yeah, I think he will actually come out swinging now, though. I think he knows where he's at, and I think he knows he's got to come out and try and put him away. Again, the only thing is he's not come out with some great combinations. he's throwing a lot of kicks, but not following up with the hands. So
well, yeah, well, I was just going to say exactly the same thing, Jamie. He needs to fire the kick in, but follow it two or three punches. You know, kick, bam, 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 kick, bam, bam, bam. He cannot be just throwing one or two shots. You know, it can't be a kick and a punch, kick and a punch. Those single shots that might only work, it's not going to work. But you need, he's got to win this round. He's got to win it big.
Yeah, he definitely has.
To go around with raffle tickets for Michael Bisping's glove signed. Raffle tickets go around now. Michael Bisping's glove signed in a frame. Thank you.
Yeah, so third and final round here in what's been a greatly fought contest.
Here we go. Well, we need Banny to come out. We've said he's got to come out fast. Can Hussein control another round?
Yeah, Banny's definitely got to come out with the pace now. He's actually not come out as a faster pace as what I thought he would, actually, Ian. Looking to telegraph quite a lot of what he's doing here.
He really is. I think maybe he's wary because he's felt the power of Hussein.
Yeah, he's hesitating a lot now.
You know, very hesitant.
You know, maybe Hussein has give quite a lot of damage to him, you know, both on the floor and standing.
Those two big right hands that he hit him, you know, when he started to close the eye up, I think they really made him think about Hussein's power.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, get behind these guys, give me encouragement, come on.
Yes, that's a little bit better there, Ian.
Yeah, you know, but strength and desperation a little bit to me. You know, he's... Now this is better. I like him to see him light on his feet and then coming in with shots, you know, not just trying to come forward in a straight line.
Yeah, you see, at the minute he's not making Hussein think much, is he? It's basically he's coming straight forward, he's doing the same thing. That high kick's coming every time, that right body kick is coming every time. Hussein knows what's coming. All he has to do is just move out of the way.
Oh, a slip from Hussein. But there again, he catches, throws the shots.
Hussein's still very dangerous though. On that back foot, as we've seen before. That's where he caught Banny with that big kick.
Well, there again.
Nice.
Yes. Really nice work. Oh, but there, Banny's... Oh,
he's had some big shots here.
He's dropped him.
He's had some big shots here.
He needs to recover here. Hussein needs to recover. He gets back to his feet, showing how tough he is.
Yeah, he's definitely a tough kid.
I mean, Banny needs a big round, but he could be two rounds down.
Yeah, he's took some big shots here, and this is exactly what Banny needs to do. And I think... Hussein now needs to get that clinch and really go for that.
I think the right thing for Hussein to do is to get the clinch, try to hold the clinch, get his head back together, and then work for a takedown.
Yeah, definitely. But Banny's still working him. Even though he's up against a KJ, Banny's throwing them knees in. You know, there's a lot of space there. For Banny, I think he can get out of that and move away. If he can. So I step that left foot over and right, and pivot on the right. Oh, it's a big shot.
Oh,
right down the pipe.
How many of these can Hussein take? He gets the takedown. Well, Hussein needs to try and ride out this round because he's took too many shots this round.
He does, but from what we've seen so far of Banny, he doesn't have much when it comes to off his back. He's not done anything off his back so far.
No, that's very, very true. Nope. I think this is where Hussein needs to stay. Just maybe try to chop in little shots. I think Banny's more likely to try and just... you know, plant one of his hands on the ground and try and do a stand-up.
Yeah, 10 seconds of this fight left now. And, you know, there's not much he can now do, but a valiant effort from Banny in that third round there, though.
Yeah, oh, he did what he
had to do. Come on, ladies, let's see if both fighters were long,
guys. That's a fight for Hussein.
You know, it's times like that, you know, it sounds like you just love fighting. You love watching fights like that, Ian. You know, both guys give it
well
all
done,
right
stop,
up until
well
the
done.
End of the third round, throwing shots, throwing bombs at each other. Great fight.
Gentlemen, let's hear for both fighters. Well done, guys. We have a unanimous decision for your winner. In the red corner, Adam Hussein. I give it up for Bani Sereba for your winner, Adam Hussein. Well done, guys. Great stuff, guys. Great work. Great work, right? Well done. Great stuff. Come on, girls, get in there, get your four other silk girls. Lap dancing bar, keep your ticket, keep your band, and have a long on down. Free entry with your band and ticket, the after party. Silks, lap dancing, bada boom, bada bing, bada bang. Woo! Well done, guys. If you've just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ritz Manchester. KO Promotions and Legacy MMA presents